Yung kauna-unahang International Eucharistic Congress ay ginanap noong taong 1881 sa Lille, France. This was done during the time of St. Peter Julian Emard, yung founder po ng Blessed Sacrament Fathers, na who with the collaboration of some lay faithful, nag-isip sila na, may pangangailangan na yung buong mundo ay magkaisa sa kanyang pagdiriwang, sa kanyang nanampalataya tungkol sa Eucharistia. No? So this is a Catholic event that celebrates the belief in the real presence of Jesus in the Eucharist. And since that time, it has taken place every 4 years in different parts of the world. Dito sa Pilipinas, we have a chance na we have been able to host this a second time this year. Kasi yung unang, noong taong 1937, ang siyudad ng Maynila was the one who hosted the International Eucharistic Congress. So basically, it is a social event, a social gathering that has reflections, conferences, devotional celebrations, and other cultural events, no, that allows people to come together to strengthen their belief and to become witnesses of their belief in the Eucharist. And now Cebu is proud to say na after 4 years of preparing for this event, we are now down to our final 3 days before the event opens on Sunday, January 24, with the opening mass at 4 o'clock in the afternoon. So I can say na Cebu is now excited to welcome all 10,000 delegates, 1,000 of which are from different parts of the world, representing 71 countries, and the rest from our country, from our mga brothers and sisters here sa Pilipinas, who will come to Cebu just for this purpose. Marami tayong mga sabihin nating VIPs, no, na magpunta for this occasion. Among them are those who will be part of the Speaker's Bureau. We have mga famous names katulad ng Archbishop ng New York, si Cardinal Dolan. Meron tayong dating master or yung General Superior ng Dominican Order, yung very famous at very charismatic speaker na si Father Radcliffe. Meron din tayong dati isa sa mga iniisip ng media na papabili, si Archbishop or Cardinal Maloney, no? Ng US. No? And then more importantly, nagpadala yung Papa, si Pope Francis, ng kanyang representative sa event na ito. Dahil yung Papa hindi na makabalik dito sa bansa dahil nagpunta siya bago lang, yung pinadala niya ay no less than the Cardinal of Myanmar, no, si Cardinal Bo. And we will get to meet Cardinal Bo when he arrives here sa Cebu, sa Pilipinas, on Saturday, January 23 in the morning. Ang Eucharist is always associated with the belief that Jesus is present in the consecrated bread that is blessed during the celebration of the Mass. It is a belief that dates back since the beginning of Christianity, na yung panho na nai-offer natin during the celebration of Mass para sa atin maging biyaya ng Diyos, because it will become for us the body of blood of Christ. Unang-unang benefit is to be proud that nai-recognize po ng simbahan yung ating pananampalataya bilang mga Kristiyanos, so much so that they have allowed us to host this event. Secondly, we are proud to say na we might be a poor people, we might come from a developing country kung sabihin natin, and compared to the other hosts tulad ng Canada, ng Ireland, and other big names ng mga European cities, ano lang ba tayo, no, in compared to that, no? But just the same, yung simbahan may nakita na there is something in our people, no, that is worth presenting before the international community. And I think basically the message is the Filipino smile frequently because he is a person of hope. And I think the world needs to be reminded that hope is something that we need, hope is something that we keep alive, and our people have it, no? And it shows in their smile, it shows in their faces. And natested na po tayo sa maraming mga pagpahihirap na nadaanan natin, including yung mga recent calamities. Yet here we are smiling and still ready to start all over again. So this is what we want to give as a gift to the world.